Here. So today, this evening, I'm playing Zombies Ate My Neighbors for the Sega Genesis. This is, if you've never played it, it's a fun game. It's very well made, the graphics are awesome, the music is awesome. It's just fun, really fun for two players, actually. It's got some really good co-op, and it's just kind of good fun. You'll see as I play it here. Let me load it up. And played this a ton back in the day. Never beat it. I don't know how far the game goes, but I'd get pretty far in the game back in the day when we'd rent it. And then I used to play it on the Super Nintendo, but I had the Genesis emulator all queued up and pretty happy with the way it looks. So the game is, I think, virtually identical for the two systems, so. You can see it's a password system, so you can't save your progress, but you can get a password to pick up where you left off. So, the basic premise is that it's like a zombie invasion or monster invasion. It's not just zombies, and you have to save all sorts of innocent people, and you're just like these punk kids with like goofy weapons. And yeah, let's just get going. Now I'm gonna be a spiky-haired guy. Because, you know, it's cool and rescue the neighbors in level one zombie panic. So you have your basic item here is we can start with a squirt gun, and you can see on the map over on the right side there are all the blinking dots. Those are the people you need to save. Oh, see they just got killed. That's not cool. So the zombies, they are drawn toward the people. So I should have probably left this guy because he's safe. But up this way, let's see who else we can find here. Doggy. Gotta save the dog. Oh. That's right, they charge you. There's one person left. Oh. Okay, so let's see if we can figure out where that person is. Oh, right there. It's a baby. So that means I need a key. So there should be one around here somewhere. So there's an item, it's a weapon. Nothing in there. Oh. See, it's got this great soundtrack to it. It's great, like, horror music soundtrack. I just love it. Where's the key? Keep on the lookout for items though, because you get to a point where this game gets pretty crazy and you're struggling for items. Where's that key? Oh, there it is. They only chase you for a second. Okay, there, I got the key. Now I can go back through that secret passage there. Find that baby. And then once you get the final person, a secret exit, or an exit shows up to the next level. And you get points based on how many you save, like a completion sort of thing. So I missed one, so I didn't get them all. But that's okay. Evening of the Undead. Now this one, yeah, this one's creepy. Music. Just great music. Save the cheerleader, save the world. I think I've heard that before somewhere. This dude's. I think the guys in the pool are safe, so if you can. If you need to save somebody else first, definitely do it, I think. see here. So we in the house. Oh, come on now. Oh, great. See, I need some keys or something. Getting these houses. Gold. Oh, there's a key. There's squirt gun, which is super important because you just run out of ammo eventually. Ooh, another key. Oh, there's somebody to save there. Oh, come on. Alright. Nothing in the garbage. Cheerleader. Okay, there's two people left. Oh, no! Oh, that makes me mad. Well, I might as well see what loot I can get in here, because there's just never enough stuff. Oh, that potion I just picked up? That's good stuff. That makes you into a creature, a monster. And you're, like, super powerful, like a wolfman or something. Alright, so I think that's about it. So we should probably get through here. Alright, level 3. Still, I missed one that time. That's frustrating. Terror in Isle 5. Oh, yeah, this level's crazy. Okay. Oha. Oh, my gosh. Dang it. These little axe throwing guys are freaking crazy. It looks like you do get to keep your keys from level to level, which is cool. Which is a nice feature, because there's times where you don't have time to find the keys to save these people. Now, there was a cheerleader in here. Somewhere. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. I should have used a health kit. I think I have a health kit even. Okay. Now, how do I change items? I may be having a problem here with my key configuration. Hold on a second. Let me check on that. Define. Up, down, left, right. A, B, C. Start. X, Y, Z. Mode. Okay, that should do it. Not letting me change my item. I wonder what that means. I may need to... I don't know what that means, to be honest. Oh, you know what? I bet it is. I have it set to behave like it's using the... There's a person right there. How do I get to them? Ow! This way. Okay, I think I'm safe in here, so I'm gonna play with those settings a little more. Sorry about this. Three button pad. Six button pad? I'm not sure why it's not being happy with me right now. Let me try. Doing that again. Up, down, left, right. A, B, C, start. X, Y, Z, select. Okay. I know I've picked up other items. Well, that's a problem. Oh. What the heck? It looks like I used an item. Like the sneakers to make you run faster. But I never saw them come up in my little screen. What am I missing? I'm missing something here. Then. Oh, of course, this level. Chainsaw Hedge Maze. This one's got my favorite music in it. Oh, great. I wasted my potion. Eventually this will wear off. Yep, now it's good. Okay, now it's time to run. Okay, so it's not letting me switch my items. For some reason, A isn't working. I don't know why. That's gonna be a problem. But I was able to at least put down a decoy. They don't like, or they go for those decoys instead of me, which is super helpful. There's the person up there. Okay. How did I get up there? I don't know where I ditched them. I don't ever remember ditching the guys that easily. I think I kind of goofed up the normal path by using that creature. Ooh. Oh no. Go for the clown, not me. Oh, here we go. So I have to hold down. Okay. Alright, I get it now. I knew I was missing something. Oh no 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 no, leave me alone. Got him. Oh, there's two more people? Where? Ow. Jeez. Oh, okay. Where are they? I totally missed them. Let's see here. What do I got for items? That's good. That's a good find. Now, where are the people I need to save? Alright, let's see here. Not sure what's best to have. Ooh. Pretty good. It doesn't take too much ammo to freeze them for just a second. Here they come. No. I never get that teacher saved. Well, at least I made it. And I figure out how to change weapons, so that's good. So you hold down A and then you push the shoot button, which is B. So now, I'm going to write that down because you never know. So, V, Y, Z, V. It's like old school days, you know? You gotta keep that password. V, Y, Z, V. Alright. Let's keep it going. Weird kids on the block. So, I've been getting kind of engrossed in the game and I haven't really been talking much about it. So as you can see though, the game is pretty, it's a pretty exciting game. Oh, that's right. So that one's interesting when you play two players, because you don't know which one. It's like body snatchers, basically. So there's a bunch of duplicates of you, and you don't really know who is the real, you know, Invasion of the Body Snatchers. So it can be pretty interesting, two players. And that's what I was going to say, is I haven't had much time to talk. I've been kind of intensely into this game. But you can see, the game is awesome. And then two players, it's super awesome. So now this stuff, I think I want to use this. Ow. Now, I... I don't know how to switch the other thing now, though. That's the tricky part. Alright, where's the other person? Over here? Army guy. He's sitting there with some bazookas. But as you can imagine, playing this with another player, good times. Controls are great. So, and by the way, I'm playing on an emulator. It's called Fusion. I've never used it before, but it seems pretty good, so I'd recommend it. The sound is really good. It's got these sound filters on it that make it sound really good. Ooh. I gotta figure out how to switch my other item so I can use my healing items. One thing at a time, I guess. So yeah, it's Fusion is the emulator. I'm playing with a little USB adapter that allows me to plug in my original PlayStation controllers, which I know are not the same as a Genesis, so you Genesis purists would probably be not very happy with that setup, but I like the PlayStation controller. It's very similar to the Super Nintendo controller, which I think is one of my favorites, and since it's an authentic one, you all know it works really well. I mean, they're super high quality. So we got mummies in this one. Mummies. Ow. Okay, I think there's a guy up here. He's about to die, though, probably. No, I made it. Amazing. I made it in time. Alright, who else we got? There's somebody. How do I get there? That way. There we go. Two more. Doing good, doing good. Ooh, I like this item. I think it kills everyone or something. Okay, that doesn't appear to be as good as I thought. Okay. Okay, I'm out of here. I know, I left that item behind. That was a bad idea, because you need tons of items in this game, especially when you get to the boss levels. But those guys were hammering on me, and I haven't figured out how to get my healing items out. Alright, where's the other person? I haven't been over here, so it might be over here. And it would be smart if I just didn't run right into them. Okay. Okay, I've been through there. See those doors, they shut behind you. It's tricky. Where are they? I feel like I've kind of been all over. I didn't miss anyone over in this top left corner, did I? No. This game is so totally like 90s. Dude's got his spiky hair. wearing the 3D glasses. So cool. Alright. Doing alright? I don't think I lost sight on that time. Is there a bonus? No, you just get points, so. Starting to run out of lives, though. Dr. Tongue's Castle of Terror. Sounds creepy. Ow. Jerks. Alright, where is everybody? I've got lots of keys. That's good. Cheerleader. Yes. I will save you. Wow, tons of keys. Let's get by here. Not waste our stuff on them, because you can't really get us once we're by there. Let's go back to the squirt gun. Aha, fire extinguisher. Tricky. Help! Well, that's a treasure. I wonder if I got myself an extra life there with that beeping noise. Oh, come on. Okay. Now, where are they? Okay, there's a cheerleader. And I'm gonna have to get through here. Oh, come on. And the baby. Okay, that leaves one. Okay, another good potion there. Aha, look at that. Tricky. Where does this go? Oh. What the? Uh-oh. What the heck? I don't remember this. Game over! That was exciting. I don't remember Frankenstein. I don't remember that doctor. That was weird. Well, let's enter my initials. Retro Gaming Dev 10. Not bad. Hey, first place. So yeah, that's Zombie at My Neighbor's. I think that's all I'm going to do for tonight. It's getting late, but as you can see, it's a really good game, and I'm definitely going to play it again. I'm kind of interested to see if I can get the net play functions of this emulator working with somebody else, and we can do some two-player. So, if there happens to be anyone out there that has used Fusion Genesis emulator or Mega Drive emulator and knows how to use the net play features, that would be great. Give me a contact on Twitter at RetroGamingDev. Otherwise, if you're just into retro gaming stuff, follow me on Twitter, RetroGamingDev. Follow me on YouTube, RetroGamingDev. And yeah, this video will be up on YouTube as well, probably. So feel free to check it out. Thanks for hanging, and next time.